Hey everybody, my name is Matt Sokup, and today I'm going to show you how to get data from CosmosDB down into your Xamarin.Forms app. This is a quick look at the app that I'm going to be talking about today. It's an app that shows contacts, data already stored up in CosmosDB, and we're taking it, bringing it down, and just displaying it. So with that said, here's the code for the app. As you can imagine, it already has a data service that goes out and hits Cosmos, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to recreate a very simple version of it so we can see how it's done from the get-go. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take it, add a new file, and I'm going to say this is going to be blog, data, service. Go through and say, yes, that is what I want. And I'm going to say it's going to be an iData service because I'm going to implement that interface. And then I'm going to go back in here, get my IntelliSense to work, and now I have everything showing up. For what I have here is I have a get nearby async and an update location async. I'm not going to be implementing those in this demo here, so I'm just going to return empty. Task.completed task. And then in this one, I'm going to say var contacts equals new grouping string contact. And actually, this is going to be a list of grouping string contact. And then return await. Make sure I do this async. Return a wait task.fromResult contacts. All right, great. That takes care of the stuff that we don't care about. What about the stuff that we do care about? So, first thing, most important thing is that we need to get the DocumentDB NuGet package. So Microsoft.Azure.DocumentDB. Already in my file, in my solution, download it, we're good to go. Second thing is I have a couple of static class level variables I want to have in here. The first one is going to be called document client, and I'm going to name it Cosmos client. And so what this thing does is it takes care of communicating from my app up to Cosmos for me. Everything's going to go through it. The second thing is going to be a URI, and I'm going to call it doc collection URI. And so what this is going to do is going to uniquely identify my DocumentDB collection where all my documents exist. And then finally, I'm going to have a Boolean called is initialize. And that's going to tell me whether I've been initialized yet or not. So obviously, the next thing I want to do here is implement my initialized. So first thing I want to do is, if I happen to already be initialized, I want to bail out of it. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to implement the doc collection. I'm just going to say doc collection URI. And there's this URI factory that comes as part of the DocumentDB NuGet package, and I can create document collection URI and passing it a database name and a collection name. So when I created the CosmosDB up in Azure portal, I gave it a database name, I gave it a collection name, and that's all I'm putting here. Next, what I want to do is I want to go out and actually create the CosmosDB client. So I'm going to do Cosmos client equals new document client, and it's going to take a URI of where the URL essentially of where Cosmos is. So that's, again, I have it in a common constants, and it's a DB URL, and then an authentication key. And what this authentication key is just a way to get at everything. It proves who I am. I am who I am. And then finally, I want to make sure my isInitialized equals true. Aha, there's one more thing, and this is very important. the Cosmos client, I can do open async, and I want to await that. So what this open async does, it pretty much primes a pump for Cosmos. I newed up my client, and now I'm going to open it up. And because I'm keeping it static, this all helps with performance. So UI factory, document collection URI, create the document client, and then open it up. So I'm all initialized. Next thing, get async. I'm getting a single document out of here. So of course, the first thing I want to do is I'm going to await the initialized. Great, everything's initialized up. So the next thing I want to have is a doc URI. So what this is going to do is I have the document collection URI, which uniquely identifies the whole collection. Because I'm only after a single document, this create document URI is going to identify a single document in it. So again, I can pass over the common constants, that database ID, the collection in which the document exists, the all CDA collection ID, and then finally, the ID of the document. And then now I can use my Cosmos client to read the document asynchronously, saying that I want a contact object out of it, then passing in the doc URI. And of course, I want to await it, and then I'm going to return that contact out of there. Make that a small C contact. Very good. So what I'm doing is I'm saying read the document async, read a single one, and here is its identifying URL to go get at it. And it's all asynchronous to go at. So I'm going to compile it, make sure I don't have any typos anywhere. And as we go through, we're debugging. It looks like we're okay, and we are. Sweet. And now the fun one, the get all async, the one where we can actually do some querying with it. So again, make market as asynchronous. And the first thing I want to do is make sure I'm initialized. Now, the second thing that I'm going to do here is I'm going to create just a return list. So I'm going to say our list of contact. After that, what I want to go through is create an object called a document query. So I'm going to say this contact query is equal to the Cosmos client that create document query. And I'm going to say I'm dealing with contacts here, and I'm going to want to pass in the doc collection URI. And I want to say as document query. Great. And I want to make sure, obviously, I want to new that up. And then at the end, I'm going to say return all contacts. So what I'm doing here is I'm saying create a document query, something I can use to query CosmosDB with. Now there's another option I can send here, and it's called feed options. And that feed options tells me how to return data from Cosmos, like how many records at once. So I can do feed options equals new feed options. And I can say max item count. And if I say -1, that says just give me back everything at once. So I'll do just send in feed options to that as well. Now, the next thing to do is in this contact query, it has a unique property that says has more records. So it says while it has more records, I can continue to do what I need to do, which is pretty neat. So you want to put that into a while loop, obviously, to keep on going around and around till you grab everything, because you can specify the max item count here. So while has more records, then I can say returned contacts equals, and here's really a neat thing we can do, execute execute next Cosmos client. It's not, it's a Cosmos query, contact query, my bad, execute next async, it's coming back as a contact, and I'm going to want to await it. And so this brings me back all the contacts that are defined by this query up here. and then I can just add them into my return list because it's an IEnumerable at that point. This is all I need to go out and grab everything to find in my collection. So let's run it, assuming I didn't make any typos. One thing I do need to change, though, is I need to make sure I have my dependency servers listening to my new iData service. And I've called it blog data service. All right, so now let's run it. Should be coming through. And here we go. It's going to go out, it's going to query Cosmos, and it's going to come back as all the CDA contacts. Great. You'll notice there's no images there. That's because the image stored up in Cosmos, it's a string of a URL, and I have to do some manipulation in order to actually display the image. So I'm not doing it here in this data service. Great. So what I want to do here is actually show off some other neat things. I can do predicates. I can say where cda.twitter.contains, and I'll say code. So anything that has the word code in their Twitter, and I'm going to say an order by, we'll do the cda.name, like that. So I can start stringing together link queries as well. So I'll run this again, and as we come up, you'll see that I'm only going to get one result back, and that's going to happen to be myself. My Twitter is CodeMailMatt. This should come up, and this will now run. And here we go. And it is just me. So the where clause worked. We can also do things like take 10. So I want the top 10 records that come back. Again, run it, it'll go through, and when we compile it, we should see the top 10 records come back ordered by name. It's gonna go query Cosmos, bring it back, and we see top 10 ordered by name. Nice. So one other thing that I just wanna point out is here you can actually say to list. You can say create document query to list, and that immediately just returns everything from that document query as a list. It blocks. You'll see some samples that do that. Don't do that. Don't do the to list. All right, so that in a nutshell is how to query CosmosDB, how to grab a single record for CosmosDB. So a couple things, never use that to list. Always do as document query so you can use the Hasmart results and the execute next. Create document URI to read documents async for a single one, and always do a static document client. That way things are gonna stick around in memory and it'll be faster performance at the end. My name is Matt Sokup. Feel free to subscribe to this YouTube channel for more tips and tricks. Catch you next time.